Hello and welcome to another Wondershare Repairit video. In today's video, I'll be talking about the world of iPhone photography, or more specifically, focusing on live photos. Are your live photos not quite coming to life the way they should be? Well, don't worry, because I'm here for you. So, grab your iPhone and let's get those live photos working flawlessly. And hey, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, drop a comment, and share this video with your friends. Otherwise, let's jump right in. Now this feature is like magic, bringing your photos to life with movement and sound. But first, you need to know how to use it, so let me break it down for you. First things first, open up the iPhone camera app. It's your gateway to capturing those awesome moments. Now, look for an icon with three concentric circles. It's usually right at the top of your screen. When you spot the icon, tap on it to enable live photos. You'll know it's active when it lights up and the line through it disappears. But the real fun starts when you view the live photo. Here's the cool part. Press and hold the screen and watch as your static photo bursts into life with motion and sound. It's like a mini movie of your memory. So there you have it. A quick and easy guide to using the live photo feature on your iPhone. Well, okay, I'll not bore you with too much talk because I'm sure you've heard a lot of that. So let's get straight to business. First, you need to open the Photos app on your iPhone. This is where all of your memories are stored, just waiting to be tweaked. Once you're in the Photos app, find the live photo you want to edit. Tap on it to open it up. Now, look for the edit option on your screen. It's usually in the top right corner. Give it a tap to start editing the length of your live photo. Next, at the bottom of the screen, you'll see the live photos icon. It looks like a set of concentric circles. Tap on that. Here's where the magic happens. You'll see a frame bar under your photo. Hold the left end of this bar and it will turn yellow. This is your cue to start dragging the bar to the point where you want your live photo to begin. And guess what? You can do the same thing at the other end of the frame bar to edit where your live photo ends. This way, you can cut out any unwanted bits at the start or end of your live photo. First up, open the Photos app on your iPhone. This is where all your photogenic adventures are stored. Find the live photo you want to change the key image for and tap on it. Once the photo is open, look for the edit icon. It's usually in the top right of the screen. Tap on this to begin the editing process. Next, you'll see the live photos icon at the bottom of the screen. Tap on that. This will show you the different frames that make up your live photo. Now, it's time to choose a new keyframe. Tap on the frame bar below the photo. This allows you to scroll through the selection of different frames. Take your time and choose the frame that you think best represents your live photo. Once you've found the perfect frame, tap Make Key Photo. This will set it as the new key image for your live photo. Finally, tap Done to save your changes. And there you go. Your live photo now has a brand new keyframe that you've chosen yourself. First, open the Photos app on your iPhone. This is your gateway to all those captured memories. Browse through and locate the live photo that you want to save a still from. Once you've found the right live photo, tap on it to open it up. Then look for the share icon. It's usually a little square with an arrow pointing up. Tap on this icon to bring up the sharing options. In the list of options that pop up, scroll until you find duplicate. Tap on that. This is the first step in creating a still from your live photo. Now, you'll see an option that says Duplicate as Still Photo. Give that a tap. What your iPhone does next is pretty neat. It automatically creates a still version of your live photo and saves it right there on your device. First, open up the iPhone Photos app. This is where all your photogenic treasures are. Next, scroll through and pick the live photo that you want to turn into a GIF. Tap on the photo to open it. Now, swipe up on the live photo. this will reveal some editing options. The Photos app gives you four options: bounce, live, long exposure, and loop. The bounce and loop options are what turn your live photo into a GIF. Tap on bounce first to see how it animates your photo. It gives your image a playful back and forth motion. Then try loop and see which effect you like more. Once you've decided on the GIF option you prefer, just leave that option selected and your iPhone will automatically convert your live photo into a GIF. Now that you're ready to share your new GIF, tap on the share button and choose where you want to send it. Social media, messaging apps, you name it. First, you'll need to visit the settings on your iPhone. Once you're in the settings, scroll down until you find camera. Tap on it to open up your camera settings. In the camera settings, look for preserve settings. Tap on that. Now you'll see a few options under preserve settings. Find the live photo option and move the slider to off white position. This will turn off the live photo feature. Next, head over to your camera app. Once you're in the app, tap on the live photo icon. This is the icon with the three concentric circles. When you disable live photos, the icon won't be lit up and there'll be a line through it. Since you chose to preserve your settings, the live photo feature will stay off. This means that every time you open your camera, it will start in the regular photo mode, not live photo mode. Now, this tool is a fantastic offline option to repair photos, and it's pretty straightforward to use. Let me guide you through the steps. Step one, load the file to repair it. First things first, you need to download and install the Wondershare Repairit tool. You can find it for both Windows and Mac. Once you've got it installed, launch the tool. After opening the tool, click on the More Types of Repair option on the left sidebar. Then click on Photo Repair. In the center of the screen, you'll see an Add button. Click on this button to upload an image file from your Mac or Windows system. This will load the photo onto the software for repair. Step two, start the repair. Now that you've selected the files that you want to repair, hit the repair button. This will start the repairing process. There's an indicator in the bottom left corner showing the progress of the repair process. Just a heads up, this process might take a few minutes, and remember, don't close the application while it's repairing your photo. Step three, restore. Once the repair process is complete, the software will show you a list of all of the repaired files. Now you can select the files that you want to restore. Once you're happy with your selection, click on the Save or Save All button. This lets the software save the files. And with that, we come to the end of today's video. I should assume that by now you know how to fix live photos on iPhone. But before I leave, kindly hit the like button and make sure you turn on notifications so that you won't miss any of our future uploads. I hope to see you in the next video.